It's always a pleasure to be the first, except if Cory Doctorow was the first before you. So I try to do my best to introduce you a topic which is a really fascinating one for copyright lawyers. I understand that there are not that many copyright lawyers, or at least not everyone is a copyright lawyer here. I therefore have to let you know that today I am just giving an introduction to this question, and I am happy to announce that tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock I have a workshop where I will continue talking about this question, plus about many other fascinating copyright issues from the European Union. Okay. The question is about exhaustion. Exhaustion is a really interesting doctrine that was developed by judges in the United States, in European countries like Germany, and at the beginning of the 20th century, but ultimately it was included into international treaties like the WIPO's copyright treaty. This is the best example for the question, and if you just look at the chart, I don't want to waste your time, but if you look at the chart, you can see that there are some fundamental doctrines or elements of doctrines included into the WCT as well, like what it really means is that the doctrine of exhaustion covers only the exhaustion of the right of distribution after the first sale of a copyrighted subject matter by the right holder or with the authorization of the right holder. And there is an agreed statement attached to WCT that says that these copies shall be fixed on the tangible medium. Why is it interesting? Definitely we are in the digital age, we are in the age of internet, and therefore many, many service providers decided to launch services that are based on the resale of digital content. One of the most interesting cases related to this question is the USAF versus Oracle case, which is coming from Germany and discovering the resale of computer programs, or at least license keys to Oracle computer programs. In this case, the USAF, which was a German company, decided to purchase license keys from users and resold these licenses to other people, definitely on a, with a great discount. However, really interestingly, they concluded a license contract with the users, with the Oracle concluded the license contract with the original purchasers of the Oracle software. And the case which ultimately reached the Court of Justice of the European Union, therefore, was about a basic question whether exhaustion applies to the sale and resale of computer software, and ultimately what is a sale, what is a license, and some further questions. The Court of Justice had to answer many, many interesting sub-questions. The first question was about this so-called sale versus license dichotomy. What is a sale? What is a first sale? Because in this case, once again, the Oracle concluded license agreements with the original purchasers. However, the judges said that the first sale is the alienation or transfer of ownership interests of tangible or over tangible and intangible goods, which is a really interesting conclusion because, once again, the case came from Germany, and in Germany, property ownership over intangibles is not present. It's prohibited in Germany. Therefore, somehow, the Court of Justice, right at the beginning of the decision, reached an incorrect conclusion. However, the judges stressed that since the license contract, which was concluded by Oracle and the end users, is for an indefinite term and allows for a permanent use on, on behalf of the users, and ultimately the Oracle received a fair compensation in exchange of this contract, this contract shall be treated as a sale. Why is it important? Once again, the exhaustion doctrine only applies for the right of distribution. Distribution is about the transfer of ownership on goods. The second question that the Court of Justice had to discuss is exactly related to the internet. Any kind of on-demand uses where people are transmitting information from one place to another and allowing access to these contents is treated clearly as a making available to the public. However, the Court of Justice interpreted this factual situation as if the sale of a good, the transfer of ownership, would transform this making available activity into a distribution activity. Why, once again, it is important is that this way the Court of Justice opened the doors for exhaustion in respect of software. The judges similarly stressed that downloading a software from the web, downloading from the website of Oracle, and ultimately installing the software on the computer of the end user, is functionally the same as if the user would purchase a CD or DVD and would install the program, the computer program, on his computer from the DVD or CD. Ultimately, what the judges said is that in respect of computer programs, the making available, communication to the public, and the distribution of a CD is functionally the same. The next thing, however, is that I highlighted the WCT's definition or provision regarding the first sale doctrine, and the agreed statement related to the WCT clearly stated that copies shall be tangible. The Court of Justice probably blinded itself when it said that in respect of computer programs, this provision is not applicable because the Information Society Directive says that it shall leave intact the acquis communautaire, the previous provisions, and especially the provisions regarding computer programs. Therefore, the judges said that this computer program directive is a so-called lex specialis compared to the Information Society directive. I jump this one, I skip this slide, and I jump to the next case, which is the Capital Records versus Strategy case. Why? Once again, in this previous Yusuf case, ultimately the judges said and concluded that the resale of computer programs shall be treated as distribution and is covered by the exhaustion. However, in the United States, Southern District of New York judge ultimately concluded that it's not correct for at least sound recordings and under the United States law. Redigi is a really interesting service where people might upload their lawfully purchased iTunes tracks to the servers of Redigi, might stream this music, might listen to the music. However, they might also sell their music, these tracks, to other users. The judges in this case have to decide whether the first sale doctrine, as it is called in the United States, covers this kind of activity or not. The judges ultimately said that it's not covered by the first sale doctrine for specific reasons. First, if users are uploading the content to the server of Redigi, they reproduce the content. And ultimately, the first sale doctrine, even in the United States, covers only the right of distribution and not the right of reproduction. Therefore, there is always an unlicensed reproduction in this situation. Second, when users are transferring the information from place A to place B, they also commit a distribution, and this might be treated as illegal, except if there is so-called affirmative defense on the side of the user. Such an affirmative defense is the so-called first sale doctrine in the United States. However, the judges said that this is not applicable because there is at least one illegal reproduction. The user is not transferring a particular copy which shall be or which is actually a prerequisite for the application of the doctrine under the US law. And finally, the judges also said that the doctrine is only applicable for or to material objects and not digital data. Ultimately, the US judge concluded the opposite way as the Court of Justice did in respect of sound recordings. What is the probable consequence of this difference between the different courts in the US and in the European Union? First, I usually like to stress that it's not a big deal what the Court of Justice said if you think on the fact that the right holders might simply refine the contractual terms, that the license terms that they of the contracts they conclude with the users. It's quite easy to exclude those elements of the terms of the contract, like the use for indefinite term and the permanent use. And if right holders can refine these terms of these license contracts, then definitely the USAF decision is not applicable for this situation. Second, however, if in a case a judge ultimately decides that the contract which is concluded by the user and original purchaser, sorry, and the right holder, if the judge treats this contract as a sale, then there is a clear danger that the purchase prices will raise, because right holders will ultimately decide to ask for more money at the first step when they are in contact with the purchasers, because if first sale doctrine applies to software and other contexts as well, they cannot ultimately ask for remuneration after for any future uses. questions regarding the functional equivalence theory that the Court of Justice used, alternative technological solutions that, for example, the RedDG implemented in order to evade those terms that the judges included into the decision, need discussion, definitely not today. I will do it tomorrow. But there is another statement I like to add I want to add to this presentation is that I was talking about digital exhaustion before, whether it's possible or not. But in any case, if cloud-based services will become the most typical way of access and enjoyment of protected subject matter, then probably the whole digital exhaustion issue or context will be meaningless, because all these models are based upon services, and services cannot fit into the right of distribution. Thank you very much for your attention.